Morning all of you. This is 11th class biology chapter 9 bio molecules and this is lecture number 2 of this chapter. Today we will study about lipids, nitrogenous bases, nucleosides and nucleotides. So lipids are water insoluble molecules. These are not soluble in water, as you can see here. And lipids contain carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, but number of oxygen atoms is less than carbon and hydrogen. So carbon and hydrogen are more in number in lipids. Now types of lipids. So there are three main types of lipids. These are simple lipids, compound lipids and derived lipids. First of all, we will talk about simple lipids. And these simple lipids are formed of fatty acids and alcohol like glycerol. So here glycerol is present with fatty acids and their combination form simple lipids. Fatty acids which are present here are lipids with a hydrocarbon chain, and that hydrocarbon chain is also called R group, right? And one carboxyl group is also present here. So this R group, which is present in fatty acid, ends in carboxyl group. So we can say in this fatty acid two things are present: the carboxyl group in the end, and attached with that carboxyl group, R group is present, right? And this R group is a hydrocarbon chain, and the number of carbon can vary in this R group because this is variable group. So different number of carbons will be present here, right? And this carboxyl group is present in all fatty acids. Now you can see one example here, like palmitic acid. It has 16 carbons. Okay, palmitic acid is a fatty acid having 16 carbons, and the formula is CH3CH2-14. So you can count the carbon here. Like CH3 1 carbon and 14 carbon are present here, 14 plus 1 15, and 1 carbon here in carboxyl group. So total 16 carbon are present here in palmitic acid, right? You can see here the structure of palmitic acid. And another example is arachidonic acid. Arachidonic acid has 20 carbons, so R group can vary in in the number of carbons. Now, types of fatty acids. So there are two types of fatty acids: saturated fatty acids and unsaturated fatty acid. Saturated fatty acids have no double bond or triple bond between carbon atoms. For example, palmitic acid and stearic acid, both these are saturated fatty acids. These have no double bond or triple bond between the carbon atoms. And unsaturated fatty acids have one or more carbon bonds. And examples of unsaturated fatty acids are oleic acid and arachidonic acid. So you need to learn these two examples for both. This is about the structure of glycerol. We have done about the fatty acid, and we know simple lipids are combination of fatty acid and glycerol. Okay, so now we will do about the structure of glycerol, which is attached with fatty acids to make lipids, right? So glycerol is also called trihydroxypropane, right? And we can see this glycerol in our chemistry lab in this form, in this liquid form. Okay, this transparent liquid you can see here is glycerol. So this is the chemical structure for glycerol. Here you can see CH2OH, CHOH and CH2OH. This is trihydroxypropane. Okay, this is propane trihydroxy. So trihydroxypropane. Now let's see how these fatty acids and glycerols are attached with each other to make lipid, to make a simple lipid. Okay, so fatty acids are esterified with glycerol. Means these are making ester bond. Okay, so fatty acids are esterified with glycerol through ester bond, forming monoglycerides, diglycerides and triglycerides. As you can see here, if one glycerol is attached with one fatty acid, the structure will be called monoglyceride, because here one fatty acid is present here, right? So it is monoglyceride. Glyceride word is coming from glycerol, and it is esterified with fatty acid. That's why it is glyceride. Okay, so monoglyceride. Second, if one glycerol is attached with two fatty acid, the structure will be called diglyceride, or you can say the lipid that will be formed will be called diglyceride. If one glycerol is attached with three fatty acids, then triglyceride will be formed, right? Now you can see here how these are formed. So as you know, this is structure for glycerol, trihydroxypropane. Okay, so with this glycerol we need to attach fatty acid. So this is the general formula for the fatty acid. Here RCOOH, this R is variable group, okay, and it can vary with the different fatty acids. So RCOOH we are taking in general, and here there will be formation of ester bond, right? And when the ester bond is formed, there is a release of water, right? So here you can see the structure of glycerol. You will write it as it is, and here with this carbon CH2OH, so this carbon will get attached here with this fatty acid with the release of water. Okay, you can see here water is released here, so OH from here and this H from here, these will form water, right? And will get release, and here this RCOO, it will get attached here with this carbon of glycerol, right? So you can see the structure now. This is same CH2OH, CH2OH, CHOH. This is also CHOH. Only this ester bond has been formed here, right? And one fatty acid has been attached here with glycerol. So this is called monoglyceride, because one fatty acid is attached with glycerol. So this is monoglyceride. Now this is diglyceride. As you can see here, because two fatty acids are attached here with two carbons of glycerol, right? As you can see here, OCOR, and two water molecules will be released from here. One from here, one ester bond will be formed here, and one water molecule will be released, and one ester bond will be formed here, and one water molecule will be released. Okay, so this is diglyceride. And likewise, if at this position also one fatty acid is attached, then it will be called triglyceride, right? So this is how monoglyceride, diglyceride and triglycerides are formed. All these are lipids, simple lipids you can say. So based on melting point, lipids are of two types. These two types are fats having higher melting point and oils having lower melting point. Now let's talk about compound lipids. Compound lipids are the esters of fatty acids and alcohol with additional groups. So here along with fatty acid and alcohol, some additional group is also present. Okay. For example, phospholipids, fatty acid plus glycerol plus phosphate. So along with the fatty acid and glycerol, phosphate is also present here, right? In simple lipids, only fatty acid and glycerols are present. But here, if the phosphate is also attached with these, it will form a compound lipid. And name of such a compound lipid is phospholipid. Phospho word is coming from the phosphate group which is attached here, right? And these phospholipids are found in cell membrane, in all the cell membranes you can see. Example is lecithin. So there can be different phospholipids. So lecithin is one example of phospholipid which is found in cell membrane. And this is the structure for lecithin. And inside the plasma membrane, these lecithin type of lipids are present, which are compound lipids. Next type of lipids are derived lipids, and these derived lipids are the products of hydrolysis of simple lipids and compound lipids. Hydrolysis means chemical breakdown of any compound due to reaction with water, right? So here simple lipids and compound lipids can react with water and can break down. okay, and due to that breakdown, derived lipids are formed. An example of derived lipids is cholesterol, and this is the structure for cholesterol. Our next topic is nitrogenous bases. These are the nitrogen containing cyclic compounds found in nucleic acids. So these are nitrogen containing compounds, cyclic, because their structure is cyclic structure. Okay, benzene rings are present here in the structure. So these are nitrogen is present here, and cyclic structure is there, and these are found in nucleic acids, means DNA and RNA. They are classified as follows. So there are two types of nitrogenous bases, mainly purines and pyrimidines. There are two purines, adenine and guanine, and three pyrimidines, cytosine, thymine and uracil. Right, now adenine is represented by A, guanine by G, and these pyrimidines like cytosine is represented by C, thymine by T, and uracil by U. All these are nitrogenous bases which are present in our DNA and RNA. These are chemical structures for adenine and guanine. Adenine is a purine, and here you can see the structure of purine is having two cyclic rings. Okay, one is 6-membered ring and one is 5-membered ring. So a 5-membered nitrogenous ring is attached with a 6-membered ring here in purine, while in pyrimidine only one ring is present, which is 6-membered. Okay, so the structure of purines is larger than structure of pyrimidines, because in purines two rings are present, while in pyrimidine only one ring is present. Right, now other things, you can count these number of carbon here. So you start counting from here. This is first carbon in this ring. Okay, so here there will be first carbon, and nitrogen is attached here obviously, because it is nitrogenous compound. So this is first carbon position, this is second, third, fourth and fifth. So with fourth and fifth position, this another ring is attached here, right? So five, then six. So these six carbon are present here. After that, with 4 and 5 position, this another ring is attached here, right? So this is 7th position of carbon, you will say, in the whole purine structure, if you are taking into account. So this will be 7th carbon, this will be 8th, and this will be 9th, right? So you need to make the structure of adenine like this. And next is structure of uracil, and in uracil only one ring will be formed here. Okay, next is nucleosides. Nucleosides are the compounds formed by linking of a nitrogen base with a sugar. So any of the nitrogen base like adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine, uracil, when these are attached with a sugar, the structure will be called nucleoside. Here one nitrogenous base plus sugar, nucleoside will be formed. Let's take some examples like adenine. If adenine is attached with sugar, then adenosine will be formed. If guanine is attached with sugar, guanosine will be formed. And if cytosine is attached with sugar, cytidine will be formed. Right? If thymine is attached with sugar, thymidine will be formed. And uracil plus sugar, uridine. Right? So here this sugar can be ribose sugar or deoxyribose sugar. That's a type of carbohydrate, you can say. Okay, so you can say when the nitrogen base is attached with the carbohydrate, the structure will be formed nucleoside. And all these are nucleosides. So you can see the difference in name, like nitrogen base name is adenine and nucleoside is adenosine. Right, guanine is nitrogenous base and guanosine is nucleoside. So cytidine, thymidine, uridine, adenosine, guanosine, all these are nucleoside. These are chemical structure for adenosine and uridine, means nucleosides. Okay, adenosine and uridine, both are nucleosides, where nitrogen base are attached with sugar. So you can see here this structure is of ribose sugar. Okay, this is 5 carbon ring. Okay, like this is first carbon here, this is second carbon, third, fourth, and this one is fifth carbon. Okay, so this structure is having 5 carbon, right? So this is ribose sugar structure of ribose sugar. If in place of OH on the second position, this is second carbon position, so if in place of OH only H is present here, then this structure will be called deoxyribose. The only one difference is there, right? So this is structure of ribose sugar, right? Now what we are saying, that ribose sugar, the sugar is attached with adenine. Okay, so here on the first position of this ribose sugar, this is first position I told you, and at the first position you can see adenine is attached with it, right? So this complete structure is called a nucleoside. And which nucleoside? Adenosine, right? So this is the structure of adenosine. First of all, you will make a ribose sugar, this a 5-membered ring you will make, right? And after that, on the first position of that, you will attach the adenine. You can also write the number of carbon if you get confused in that. Like, start from here, this is first carbon, this is second, third, fourth, and fifth carbon. Like this you can write, right? After that, this is structure of uridine, and here also we are taking a ribose sugar. Okay, you can see this OH here. Just you need to see the second position of the sugar. If here OH is attached here, then you will say this is deoxyribose sugar. If OH is attached here, then you will say it is ribose sugar, right? And the remaining structure will be same, like, because it's a structure of ribose, so it will remain same. Only at the first position of it, here uracil is attached, right? So this is structure for uridine. Next is nucleotides. These nucleotides are also formed of nitrogenous bases. So how these are formed, let's see. So these are compounds formed by linking of a nucleoside with a phosphate. And you know what is nucleoside? Nucleoside means nitrogen base plus sugar. Okay, and when with this structure, with this nitrogen base plus sugar, when a phosphate get attached, then the complete structure will be called a nucleotide, right? So let's see here, nitrogenous base plus sugar plus phosphate, it will be nucleotide. So we can take all these example, like we have a nitrogenous base like adenine. Adenine plus sugar plus phosphate will be formed, form adenylic acid. Then guanine plus sugar plus phosphate will form guanylic acid. Then cytosine will form cytidylic acid. Thymine will form thymidylic acid, and uracil will make uridylic acid. Okay, so all these are nucleotides which are formed by the attachment of sugar and phosphate with all these nitrogenous bases, right? And you can see the structure of one of the nucleotide here, like this is nucleotide adenylic acid. So first of all, you will make this 5 carbon ring, which is ribose sugar, right? And ribose sugar first position, there will be attachment of nitrogen base. So because this is adenylic acid, so obviously adenine is attached here, right? Now you know phosphate is also attached here with these two. Okay, so you see here at the fifth carbon, phosphate is attached. Okay, CH2OH should be there. So this phosphate is attached here, P, and forming OH double bond O, like this. So this is structure for adenylic acid, or you can say nucleotide. Now, based on today's topics, your homework is NCERT question number 7, and also you need to make chemical structure of guanosine and guanylic acid. Also write the difference between these two, means between guanosine and guanylic acid. Now let's discuss the homework solution of previous lecture. This is question number 1 of NCERT. What are macromolecules, and give examples. So macromolecules are the biomolecules that are formed by the polymerization of a huge number of micromolecules. Okay. Now we are studying about the micromolecules, as you know, that we have studied about amino acids. Like, okay, so many amino acids, when combined together, they make a macromolecule like protein. Okay, so we can say here that polymerization of a huge number of micromolecules make a macromolecule, right? For example, protein is a macromolecule which is formed due to polymerization of many amino acids, and amino acids are micromolecules. Next is question number 11 of NCERT, and here you need to draw the structure of amino acid alanine. So this is the simplest structure, you can say, of any amino acid. Like, you know, these three groups are fixed for any amino acid. There will be one carboxyl group, there will be one amino group, and one hydrogen will be there. Okay, and here this is R group. This can be variable, and for the alanine, this R group is CH3. Okay, so you just need to learn it and make the structure of alanine.